declared on behalf of National Vector-Borne Disease Control Program, Government of India, to be with you this morning. And also at the same time, to be associated with ASSOCHAM, the Associated Chambers of Commerce and Industry of India, in this great mission of control of vector-borne diseases in the country. Basically, conceptualization and understanding of the varied spectrum of vector-borne diseases, particularly in view of the changing epidemiology of the disease, human behavioral pattern, complex interplay of factors between agent, host, and environment, the socio-economic context are crucial for addressing strategies for prevention and control of vector-borne diseases. India is a big country with 1.2 billion people living in 700 districts and in more than 650,000 villages, with diverse social, economic, and geophysical context. Dengue, the fastest growing mosquito-borne viral disease, are endemic throughout the country in all the 36 states and even territories. There are reports of occurrence in increased numbers of cases in the recent years of chikungunya. 80% of the malaria cases in our country are reported from the areas where only 20% of the population live. These are difficult areas, hilly areas, tribal areas, particularly in northeastern states of the country, in Odisha, Jharkhand, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, and Vidarbha region of Maharashtra. At least 600 million people, they are at risk of lymphatic filariasis. Kalaazar is endemic in the states of Bihar, Jharkhand, West Bengal, and eastern part of Uttar Pradesh, especially amongst the disadvantaged, marginalized, poor people of our country. Japanese encephalitis is prevalent in 21 states. Apart from this, there are reports of endemicity of scrub typhus in most regions of our country. In certain areas, There are vector-borne diseases like Castanol forest disease, Crimea, Congo, hemorrhagic fever with high mortality.